The world and the mind of the Windows 7 user has fascinated me for quite a few years now. I don't mean back when Windows 7 was still the current operating system. I was using it back then, and I don't even mean going into Windows 8 or even early Windows 10. I mean the people that are still using Windows 7 now. And I don't mean your grandma that bought a laptop 14 years ago, doesn't know what an operating system is, barely knows what a computer is, just has a computer there, and the limited amount of computer work they need to do, it's fine for. I mean the community of people who actively go out of their way to continue using Windows 7, many of them not as like, oh, this is like a nice retro machine to go and play the Windows 7 games. I mean people who actually daily drive Windows 7 as if you should still be doing so. Yes, these people exist. Yes, there are communities of them. I wish I knew why. These are people not using air gap machines. These are people playing online games. These are people using web browsers and going around the web as if there is no problem whatsoever using Windows 7. These are people that play online games. These are people that browse the web as if there is no problem whatsoever connecting a Windows 7 machine to the internet. There are still browsers that work on Windows 7 that are actually like updated to make sure that modern websites work, because you can use Internet Explorer, you can use an old version of Chrome. A lot of sites aren't like super happy about that though. So we have things like Red Fox, a fork of Firefox for Windows 7 and Vista. There is Supermium, which is a Chromium fork to get it working on XP and up. And also, you might not know about this, and this is kind of part of the reason why things like Red Fox exist, there is Firefox ESR, which still has support in the 1.15 release, at least for now. It is going to be dropping it at some point very soon, March 2025. So I'm sure for those Windows 7 users who still care about security, which is a weird sentence to say, Windows 7 in 2024 caring about security, but they still exist to some extent and they still like cope about it. I'm sure those people are going to be kind of angry when this support is finally dropped and then eventually when sites start to break in that older version. I don't know why a lot of these people aren't just using a Linux distro at this point, right? Like, I get having this nostalgia for Windows 7, and I totally get having an air-gapped gaming machine like people do for like a Windows 98 machine, but still actively using it as your daily driver. Baffles me. Now, here's the thing, right? I would have initially thought, oh, they're just running a 4-year out-of-date operating system that is horribly insecure. Now, I'm sure a lot of them are. Don't get me wrong there. I have absolutely no doubt a lot of these people have no idea what they're doing. They just install Windows 7 because Windows 7 is good or something. But there's been some work to make it somewhat more sensible. So for most people, Windows 7 support ended on January 14th, 2020. But of course, a lot of companies are just not ready to move then, even though they were given quite a bit of warning. You have, you know, cash registers and business computers and all this stuff. So like Red Hat, like Oracle, like SUSE, and every other company that has some sort of operating system, you could pay Microsoft money to extend this support period. Enterprise support ended on January 10th, 2023. However, Microsoft still technically had one more branch of what they called Windows 7, and that still had support. Okay, so remember back in 2014 when Windows XP support ended, you might remember how people would still install a registry hack that would get them security updates until 2019 by making Windows install security updates for Windows Embedded POS Ready 2009. This is what people did back when Steam dropped support for Windows XP as well. Yeah, we're basically doing that again. Windows Embedded POS Ready 7 released on September 10th, 2011, and it had its last day of extended support on October 8th, 2024. So that is another nail in the coffin of Windows 7, because people were taking updates from this system and then bringing them over to regular Windows 7 in places where they're applicable and still getting security updates because it's close enough to Windows 7 that it kinda just works. But now Microsoft, no longer in any capacity, supports Windows 7. Technically, and we'll get to that in a moment as well. Now, stupid old me thought, oh, well, surely Steam is gonna be the last nail in the coffin, because a lot of the people in Windows 7 are still gamers, and, you know, they wanna use Windows 7 for gaming for some unthinkable reason. And on January 1st, 2024, Windows 7, Windows 8, and Windows 8.1 were fully dropped by the Steam client. Now, dropped as in support, at the time it was still working, because they didn't go out of their way to break compatibility by pushing some updates saying, hey, you're no longer allowed to use this, but if something did break and something became a problem, hey, you know, it is what it is, it's your problem now, we told you it's not supported, use something different. You know, go and use any sensible operating system choice, whether it's Windows 10, Windows 11, or if you don't want to use Windows now because you think the newer versions of Windows suck, just install a Linux distro. Go on, do it. There are so few games that you would even want to play on Windows 7 that are still problematic on Linux. Just do it. And it looks like the day of a breaking change has finally come. People opened up Steam, or at least tried to, and noticed a problem. Steam fatal error. Steam is no longer supported on your operating system version. And we've mentioned this in a different context, but Valve recently did an update to the Steam client on November 5th. And I'm genuinely surprised they even made a note of this. This version of the Steam client will no longer run on Windows 7 or Windows 8. Users on those OS versions will not automatically update to this new version of the Steam client. See the Windows 7 and Windows 8 support FAQ for additional details. Honestly, if I was Valve, I just would have said nothing, just not even acknowledge that Windows 7 exists anymore. If people complain about it, if people post on the forums, if there are articles or anything like that, just don't acknowledge any of it. You already said support ended on January 1st, 2024. You'd given so much warning up until this point, it is no longer your problem. And anyone who complains about, hey, I don't care anymore, stop using Windows 7. Now, it's not mentioned in the release notes, but what appears to be the issue is a bump in the Chromium version that fully drops support for Windows 7. However, we're already in this deep, so you know there is no way that some people are going to fully give up. They are going to try their absolute hardest to hold on to Windows 7. So most people aren't even anywhere near this update because they've been modifying a config file to block Steam from updating for quite a long time. Apparently, some people have been using a hacked Steam binary to circumvent the problem, and if you did accidentally update and left yourself with a broken installation, there is still a solution, because you can search online for a Steam binary and just install a version of Steam from just before the lockout was done. I'm not going to link you to where you can find those. You can find those relatively easily, but you could just use an operating system that's supported. Like, that is also an option, right? But also, there is there is this thing. VXKEX, or VXKEX, VXKEX, Windows 7 API extensions. It's basically a thing to enable some additional functionality in Windows 7 to make Windows 8, 8.1, and 10 applications run on 7. It's not perfect, but apparently it's good enough for this version of Steam. So if you want to use the newest version of Steam, like, that is also like an option as well. It's effectively like, it's not exactly the same thing, but it's like, it's effectively like Wine or DXVK for a Windows user. It's just Wine for a newer version of Windows. It is only a matter of time until Valve changes something in the Steam download servers that changes how downloads are done, that breaks some of these old Steam client installations, because right now they still work, but like, there's gonna come a point where things don't. And then I guess you have to download the game on another system and then transfer the game over and then hope that like the Steam, you know, store DRM stuff all just functions like it should, which at some point is also gonna break as well. But until then, the Windows 7 diehards will continue fighting on. Now, whilst Windows 7 is technically unsupported from Microsoft, like with that embedded system, there are other things from Microsoft that are close enough to Windows 7 that some of these psychos have been taking updates from and then bringing them over to Windows 7 to just keep it going. There is this thing called Windows Server, specifically 2008 R2. Now, standard support for this thing is already long over, but being a server focused thing, people are gonna run it, you know, way longer than anybody really should, and this does still have paid support until January 13th, 2026. Following that, there is also the 2012 version of Windows Server, which I have no doubt that they're going to start relying on next, and in some form, probably already do rely on. Again, like with that embedded system, people have been taking the Windows Server updates, extracting those from Windows Server, taking what is relevant from Windows Server on Windows 7 because they're close enough and it basically works and well enough with some tweaking, and putting all this effort in to somehow get a remotely kind of safe version of Windows 7 running in 2024. Now, I'm sure there is a lot of giant gaping holes even with this that are not being patched that, you know, can very well be exploited, let alone all the people that are not doing this, who are just installing Windows 7 and installing a modern browser and doing very little else, the people that are like relying on the latest service pack from Microsoft. So, you know, I still don't think it's a good idea. Honestly, the main reason I don't think it's a good idea is this is so much additional effort just to make an abandoned, unsupported operating system somewhat kind of safe to use, but you're not really certain because you can't really tell because you don't have the source code and you don't actually know all of the exploits that people are, like, you know, discovering. And I wouldn't recommend putting a Windows 7 machine anywhere near the internet. Yes, there is still antivirus that still works for it for now, assuming you have that installed. Again, the people who are actually going through the steps to install it, for the people who don't, if you are running it on the internet, people seem to think that because developers are targeting or hackers are targeting Windows 10 and Windows 11, that those exploits are not going to work on Windows 7, and it doesn't work like that. Windows 10 is a direct continuation of the Windows 7 code base, and there is a lot of problems that existed in Windows 7 that still exist in Windows 10, and there's a lot of code that is still out there that is specifically targeting those older machines because there is still quite a few people out there who are using Windows 7, and people don't need to write new exploits for Windows 7 because the unpatched exploits for Windows 7 will always be unpatched, except for the ones who are, like, you know, grabbing Windows Server updates, those weird people. I know I'm joking about this, but there is a worrying number of people who just probably won't ever leave Windows 7. They're gonna try really, really hard to stay on it. Now, some of those people will eventually realize this is a giant waste of time, and you're much better off doing literally anything else with it. But, you know, if you're doing it as a hobby, like, that's one thing, right? Like, if you like Windows 7, it's a fun thing, hey, I want to make it safe, hey, more power to you. But like, if you genuinely think the Windows 7 is a good option to go with in 2024, you are delusional. Now, speaking of delusional, there are some people moving to Windows 10 and then using things like Reloaded 7. This is a really sketchy looking website that kind of looks like it's impersonating the Windows, like an old Windows 7 website. And it's like this proprietary project that modifies Windows 10 to make it look like Windows 7 and is probably safe, probably. I can't confirm if it is or if it is not. On their website, they say United States instead of United States, so, if you want to do that, hey, go and do so. Or again, there's this world of Linux you could try. Whilst I think this whole endeavor is a giant waste of time and a giant waste of effort, I do somewhat respect the perseverance and insanity of people trying to make Windows 7 work instead of doing something sensible, right? Like, if you're... Why is this out of focus? Get in focus, damn it. There we go. If you're actually someone going through the effort of making this happen, I do think it's cool, even though I think no one should use it. But what do you think? When was the last time you actually used Windows 7, right? Have you used it after 2020, after support was dropped? Are you someone that still has a Windows 7 machine connected to the internet? If you are, I really want to know why. Please let me know down below. And if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Libera Pay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and please don't. Just don't. Money, then I don't accept.